In today's class, we will study one more type of the antenna, so that is log periodic antenna. In general, the antennas which are specified in terms of angles are called as frequency independent antennas. The basic characteristic of this antenna is that the radiation resistance and the radiation patterns of these antennas are frequency independent. The basic concept to obtain the frequency independence is the antenna must be adjustable. That is, the antenna must be either contracted or expanded in proportion to the wavelength. Log periodic antenna is the one which comes under the category of frequency independent antennas. Such log periodic antennas are having very large bandwidth and good directivity. Log periodic antenna is the one which contains number of dipoles and other antenna elements are arranged in such a way that it forms a constant angle array. In these antennas, as the frequency of the signal changes, the active element of an antenna will change from one end to the other end. Log periodic antennas are available in different types and physical appearance, but all the types have a unique characteristic that both radiation resistance and radiation patterns are frequency independent. To achieve a bandwidth of 10:1, the antenna structure is repetitive in nature. A basic realization of log periodic antenna is shown in the figure. So this is the basic realization of log periodic antenna. The basic realization of log periodic antenna is shown in this particular figure. So this is the conducting plate, and in this particular conducting plate, where so the teeth have been cut. So that is, this is a plane structure consisting of two edge-shaped metal structures with teeth cut into themselves along a circular arc. In this, the teeth are cut in a such a way that it forms a circular arc. The feature of the structure is that the radius of the arm, which defines the location of the successive teeth, are with a constant ratio, so given by tau is equal to Rn plus 1 divided by Rn. Now, so if this is Rn is the radius of the first teeth and Rn plus 1 is the radius of the second teeth, then as you move from one teeth to the other teeth, this ratio Rn plus 1 to the Rn remains constant. The ratio tau equal to Rn plus 1 divided by Rn defines the length and width of the successive teeth along the radia. When such an antenna is energized at a vertex, then it exhibits some properties. That is, the properties exhibited by such type of the structures at a frequency f will be repeated at all the frequencies given by tau raised to n into f, where n is an integer and f is the frequency. When these frequencies are plotted on the logarithm scale, it is observed that all are spaced equally with a period equal to the logarithm of t. Because of such property, these antennas are named as log periodic antenna or logarithmic periodic antennas. In general, the log periodic antennas are bidirectional. It equally radiates on both the sides of the plane, while non-periodic log periodic antennas are obtained by bending two arcs of the planar structure, which forms a V-shaped structures. That is, by bending two arms of this planar structure, we are forming a non-planar structure which is having a V-shaped structure. Such a non-planar antenna radiates in only one direction, that is of the apex. Similar to the planar log periodic antenna, non-planar log periodic antenna are having an impedance that is almost constant. Thank you. the structure of log periodic dipole array is shown in this figure. It consisting of number of dipole elements and other antenna elements which is arranged in this particular form. Here, so these are so dipole elements, and these dipole elements are interconnected together, and the length of these dipole elements and the spacing between the dipole elements will change as you move from one end of the antenna to the other end of the antenna, and this is the point we are feeding the input signal to this particular antenna. Log periodic antenna is basically a broadband antenna in which the geometry of the structure is adjusted in such a way that all the electrical properties of the antenna is repeated periodically with the logarithm of the frequency. Thus, the basic structure is repeated with the structure size changed. Because as you look into this particular figure, so the basic structure is repeated from one point to the other particular point, and as the size has been changed. That is, the basic structure is repeated with the structure change. And for every repetition, the structure size changes by a constant scaling factor with which structure can expand or contract. The length of the dipole increases from the feed point towards the end such that included angle alpha remains constant. So that is, as you move from the feed point toward this particular end, the size of the dipole increases provided the included angle alpha remains constant. The increase in length of the dipoles and the spacing in wavelengths between the two dipoles are adjusted such that the dimension of the adjacent dipole possesses certain ratio with each other. That is, the length of the dipoles and the spacing between the dipoles are adjusted in such a way that all the dipoles possesses a certain ratio with each other. the dipole length and the spacing between the dipoles are related through a parameter called as design ratio or the scale factor denoted by tau. Tau is equal to Sn divided by Sn plus 1, or this is equal to Ln divided by Ln plus 1, where Ln, Ln plus 1, Sn and Sn plus 1 are shown in these figures, where tau is called as a periodicity factor which is always less than 1. So this equation, you can write it in another form, Sn plus 1 divided by Sn equal to Ln plus 1 divided by L. So this is equal to 1 by 2 and this is equal to K. That is, so the same expression is written in terms of K. Depending upon the length of the dipoles, we get three transmission regions. One is inactive transmission region, where the length of the dipoles is less than lambda by 2. Active region, where the length of the dipoles is nearly equal to lambda by 2. And inactive region, where the length of the dipoles is greater than lambda by 2. In inactive transmission region, where the length of the dipole is less than lambda by 2, so therefore they offers a capacitive reactance or the impedance, and the element spacing in this particular region is very small, the currents in the element is very small, so therefore the region is called as inactive. In this region, the currents leads the applied voltage by the transmission line. Now consider the second region, active region, where the length of the dipole element is equal to lambda by 2, and this is the central part of the antenna which provides the maximum radiations. This part of the antenna provides resistive impedance, thus the currents are large in value and are in phase with the base voltage. The next is inactive or the stop region, where the length of the dipole is greater than lambda by 2. And these elements or this region provides inductive impedance, and the currents in this region lags the base voltage, and this region is also called as reflective region. Thus, when the wavelength is equal to lambda, the radiation occurs from the central part of the antenna, and when the wavelength increases, the active region moves toward the right side, and when the wavelength decreases, the active region moves toward the left hand side. to find the relation between the apex angle, spacing between the dipole elements and the length of the dipole elements. So consider a part of log periodic dipole array, which is shown in figure. That is, the geometry of the log periodic array is shown in this particular figure, where that apex angle have been shown. So length and the spacing between the elements are shown. And from the figure, we can write tan alpha is equal to ln plus 1 minus ln, so divided by 2, so divided by s. Therefore, tan alpha equal to ln plus 1 minus ln divided by 2s. And this equation, you can write in the modified form, tan alpha is equal to 1 minus ln divided by ln plus 1 into ln plus 1 and divided by 2s. So this rewriting is done in order to simplify the equations. Then tan alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by k into ln plus 1, so divided by 2. And here we have written it as k because we know that ln plus 1 divided by ln equal to k. So that is ln divided by ln plus 1 equal to 1 by k. Then for the active region, ln plus 1 is equal to lambda by 2. Then in this place, substitute ln plus 1 is equal to lambda by 2. Therefore, then this equation becomes tan alpha equal to 1 minus 1 by k into lambda by 2 divided by 2s. And this is equal to 1 minus 1 by k divided by 4 into s by lambda. Then this equation, you can write it once again. Tan alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by k divided by 4sk, where alpha is the apex angle, k is the scale factor, and sk is the spacing in wavelength and the short word of lambda by 2 element. The length of the element, say n plus 1 element, and the length of the first element are related by. That is, the length of the first element and length of n plus 1th element are related by ln plus 1 divided by L1 is equal to k raised to n, and this is equal to f, and this ratio is called as a bandwidth. the relation between apex angle alpha, scale factor k, and spacing sk with optimum design line and gain is shown in the figure. The relationship between apex angle alpha, scale factor k, and the spacing sk with optimum design line and gain are shown in this particular figure. Along this axis, we are having a scale factor, we are having a directivity, and we are having a space factor. And so the optimum value of spacing, so what we are getting here is sk is equal to 0.166, and the directivity or the gain is equal to 0.85. The number of elements of an array are obtained from the upper frequency and the lower frequency, which are related by this equation, that is log of fu minus log of fl is equal to n minus 1 into log of 1 by k, where fu is the upper frequency and fl is the lower frequency. Fu is design a log periodic dipole array having a directivity of 8.5 dB over a frequency of 10 MHz to 30 MHz. That is, we have one dipole array whose directivity is given as 8.5 dB and the operating frequency is from 10 MHz to 30 MHz. To solve this particular problem, from the design curve, the directivity of 8.5 dB, the scale factor k is equal to 0.895, and the spacing sk is equal to 0.166, which you have seen in the previous figure. The apex angle can be obtained from the equation tan alpha is equal to 1 minus k divided by 4sk. In this, substitute the values of k and sk, you will get the value is equal to 0.15813. Therefore, alpha equal to 8.99 degrees. The number of elements in the array is given by the equation log of fu minus log of fl is equal to n minus 1 into log of 1 by k. And in the given problem, fu equal to 30 megahertz, fl equal to 10 megahertz, and k is equal to 0.895. Substitute all the values in this particular equation. We will get the value is equal to 10.9035. Now, we will rounding it to the nearest integer. So, we are going to get it as 11. That is, the number of elements required is 11. Now, let us calculate the length of the dipoles. The length of the last dipole is equal to L11 is equal to 1 by 2 into C by FL. So, this is equal to 1 by 2, C equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 8. FL is 10 into 10 to the power of 6. This is equal to 15 meters. And we know that LN divided by LN plus 1 is equal to K. That value is equal to 0.895. Therefore, L10 equal to K into L11, so this is equal to 0.895 into 15, this is going to be 13.425 meters. L9 equal to K into L10, this is equal to 0.895 into 13.42, this is equal to 12.0153 meters. L8 equal to K into L9, substitute the values of K and L9 value what you have calculated, we are getting it as 10.753. Then L7 equal to K into L8, K value is 0.895, L8 equal to 10.753, so this value is equal to 9.62 meters. L6 equal to K into L7, K value is 0.895. L7 value you have calculated here. Substitute here, you are getting 8.6 meters. L5 is equal to K into L6. K equal to 0.895. L6 equal to 8.614 meter you have calculated. Substitute here, you will get 7.709 meters. L4 equal to K into L5. K value is equal to 0.895. L5 is 7.7095. So this is equal to 6.9 meters. Similarly, L3, L2 and L1. Once we calculate the length of the dipoles, then we need to calculate the distance between the dipoles. The distance between the dipoles is given by the equation ln divided by 2 tan of alpha. Now go on substituting the values of n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now S1 equal to L1 divided by 2 tan alpha. L1 we have calculated. Substitute the values of L1. Then 2 tan of alpha you have calculated 8.99, you are getting the value equal to 15.6337 meters. S2 equal to L2 divided by 2 tan of alpha. L2 already you have calculated, substitute here, and 2 tan of alpha will get the value equal to 17.4687. S3 equal to L3 divided by 2 tan of alpha. L3 already calculated 6.1755. divided by 2 tan of alpha, we will get 19.518. And S4 equal to L4 divided by 2 tan of alpha. So this is equal to 6.9 divided by 2 tan of alpha. So this value is equal to 21.80 meters. In a similar manner, you can calculate S5, S6, S7, S8, S9, S10 and S11. And this is all about the log periodic antenna.